You are planning to integrate a camera functionality into your Jetpack Compose Android app? Then stay tuned to learn how. Hi guys, my name is Janne Greis, I hope you're doing well and I welcome you to a new video. While the camera is nowadays often the main selling point of a new smartphone, it has always been a hassle to integrate in-app camera functionalities in an Android app. While in the old days we had to use the Camera One API to integrate an in-app camera feature into our Android apps, in the recent years Google provided us the CameraX library. It's a support library that really helps us to integrate such a feature into our Android apps. However, for Jetpack Compose, there are still no direct implementation for this library. But don't worry, there is a way to use it in your Jetpack Compose app, which I'm going to show you in this video. So let's waste no time and get started. Now in Android Studio, I already prepared a small example project, which I will provide for you in a GitHub repository, which I will link down in the description. However, let's go step by step through the process of implementing this feature in Jetpack Compose. So the first thing we need to do is to go into our build.gradle app file. And here it's important that we add these dependencies here. The CameraX version, which I'm using here right now, is 1.3.0 alpha 07, but you can also use the stable version. Should be no problem. Next, we go into our main activity and you can see that I have here a main screen. Nothing more, it's a regular Jetpack Compose setup. And if we go in here, we have a main screen. And as you can see, we also have a camera permission state. And this camera permission state is of the accompanist library, as you can see here. So if you also want to use it, use the com.google accompanist permissions library, and then you can also do the same like I do here, because I am checking here if my app has the camera permission. And of course, if you have ever implemented a camera functionality, you know that you need to go to the Android manifest and also need to check that you added the use permissions camera here. But as you can see, the user's permission is underlined in red and you can see permission exists without corresponding hardware use, use feature, Android name, Android hardware camera. So this is also required and we can simply copy it and add it here. Here we also need the Android prefix and then we also need to close the tag and should be fine. Next, we go back to our main screen and you can see that we have here the main screen and then the main content. And in this main content, you can see that I simply check for the has permission state, which comes from the permission state object here. And if we have the permission, we show the camera screen, which we will see in a second. And if we have no permission to use the camera, you can see that we here have a placeholder screen, no permission screen, and we add here the callback for asking for the permission. So let's quickly take a look into the no permission screen. And as you can see, it's a simple screen. We have a column, we have an explanation text that we need the camera functionality and also a button to trigger this permission request. And just to mention, also a simple icon here and the button text. So now that we discussed the setup, let's come to the interesting part. We go back and go into the camera screen composable. And you can see that we here have the camera content. And this is the place where we actually want to implement our in-app camera preview. So our final goal is that we open up our app and we can see the camera preview of our camera and do some stuff with it later. As already mentioned, we cannot directly use the CameraX functionalities, but we can make use of it by a little trick. We can say use the Android view. This composable allows us to use views from the legacy view system. Let's say Android view, and here we use this factory function to initialize our preview. So as you can see, we have here the context as input. And with this context, we can now say preview view. And here we now input this context. So that this preview also fills out the screen, we additionally need to set some parameters. The first thing we need to set here are the layout params. So let's say layout params, and then we can simply say linear layout params. And then here we can say the width and the height. So we say match parent for the width, and also match parent for the height, because we want to have a full camera preview. If you have another use case, of course you need to adapt it. Say what is the background color of the preview we want to have, and this is only relevant if the camera is not open yet and we have a loading state, for example. So here we can say color black, and we take the Android graphics, not the Compose version. And then we also say scale type, which comes from the preview. And here we say preview view scale type, and then we say fill start. So that helps us to avoid some cropping issues on some devices. Additionally, we also want to add a modifier to the Android view, and here we say padding, and we take the inner padding here. And what we also want to do is to add fill max size, so we fill out the whole screen. Now we have already the preview in place. If we would start the app, we would see that nothing happens. We only see the black screen. That's why we also need a camera controller. To get the camera controller in place, we first introduce here the context. We say local context.current. And we also say lifecycle owner, local lifecycle owner current. And finally, we also need the camera controller. So we say camera controller member, lifecycle camera controller, and here we add the context. So now we only need to import and are fine. So the lifecycle camera controller is actually what comes from the CameraX library and contains a lot of helper functionalities that really facilitates the implementation process. So to connect it to the preview view, we first say here also, so we can access the created preview view, which returned from this factory. And now we can say preview view, and then we say preview view dot controller, and we assign our camera controller to it. Next, we only need to say camera controller dot bind to lifecycle, and here comes the lifecycle owner to play. So the camera controller reacts on lifecycle changes. So if the lifecycle owner gets destroyed, the connection to the camera controller also automatically gets destroyed. We can make sure that this is true by going into the documentation here, and we can see when the lifecycle owner state is start or greater, the controller receives camera data. It stops once the lifecycle owner is destroyed. Now that we also got our camera controller into place, let's try out what actually happens if we start the app. So the app got started, and you can see here is our no permission screen. So now in order to access the camera, I click on grant permission, and we get prompted with this permission dialog. I say while using the app, I allow this permission, and now you can see the default dummy emulator camera screen here. So it worked. Well, it's already cool that we have the camera preview in place. Let's actually do something with our camera preview. So as a common use case, we want to take a photo, and with CameraX, that's also very easy to do. So we just need to tweak our code a little bit. Let's say we also have a button to actually take a photo. So we use a floating action button for that. So we say here floating action button, use the extended version and say text take photo, and on click we actually access the camera controller and say take picture. Let's quickly format that here, and now to access here the take picture function, we also need to put in an executor, and here we can simply say main executor and then context compat get main executor. We once again can input the context here, and then additionally we also need to use the image capture on image captured callback. Also import it. So and in here we can say override, and we have a callback for on captured success and one for the on error. So if you want to capture a photo, you can say on capture success and use the image proxy to, for example, convert the image to a bitmap. However, note that these images from the image proxy are not rotated, so that is your responsibility. And also, if you're done processing this image proxy, make sure that you call .close here. So, and that's how you can implement a camera preview in Jetpack Compose. Did you make already own experiences with this API in Jetpack Compose? Did you stumble about any limitations? Leave me a comment with your opinion. As a last word, I hope that Google someday provides an own Jetpack Compose version of the CameraX library, but this way I showed you in this video is also okay for the moment. Do you want to see any other tutorials of this topic, for example, video capturing or image analysis? Then let me know. As always, I hope you had some takeaways. Like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, activate the notification bell, and I hope to see you soon.